So hello and welcome to another gold panning adventure. We have just been given permission to try out this burn. I'll not be showing too many shots round about because it's a secret location, and obviously if I find a lot of gold I wouldn't want to be telling anybody, as you do. But I'll go for now. I'll let you watch me sluice this. I've just set the sluice up and I've started building, digging out a trench. So I'm just going to try out the first pan. I forgot my bucket today, so I just need to do it pan by pan, run it through the sluice. I think I've got the sluice running a lot better today. Seems to have the V's. What Daz P was telling me, ED was telling me as well, and Highland Gold was explaining how to run the sluice a bit better. So I'll stop blathering on and we'll run some duck through the sluice. So I've got another one. I'll show you what I'm doing here. Digging a big trench right out to there, as deep down as I can get it. But I've just looked again, lots of black sand, signs of garnets. I'll show you that there. See lots of black sand sitting right here. Right in this corner here. So I'll set up again, I'll run this through. Let's give it a pan, see what we've got, if anything. But I need to dig deeper, I think. Don't think I'm dug deep enough yet. So we're on to our third run. I think this will be the last one today. I'm struggling to pick up the big boulders. I need to get myself a pinch bar and try and get the big boulders out right down the bottom here. But this should be the most interesting one, hopefully, if I'm deep enough. But I'm going to go and try and dig a wee bit further down and then we'll see what happens for you.
If it was easy, everybody would be doing it. But it's just fun, just another treasure hunt. Really need a pinch bar, or I think I just needed a pinch bar to try and get these rocks out. One of them must be about that size at least, right down in this hole here. Sometimes you're better just to pick them out of your hand, if you can get your fingers in a tween and pull them out. A big one here, I need to try and get this to get to the rest of the gravel. It's a nice windy day today, no midges or anything. It's always good when you don't get midges.
So I've got a wee seat. This hole to clear so I can show you what it's like in there, how deep I got down. I'll probably get down just before the handle and then I hit the big boulders and I can't get down any further, but we'll finish this last one and then we'll clean this out. Thanks again to PD Highland Gold, Mr. Daz P, Digging 606, I think mentioned it to me as well, about the bees. Thanks again. So, we'll pan this through, sluice this through, and then see what happens. If anybody knows, like, I'm sure somebody will be able to tell me, like, how long can I leave the sluice in the water for? Can I just keep it going, or do I have to take it out within so many minutes? I'm not too sure on that. So I'll give you a look at the sluice again. I'm telling you, the sluice really makes it easier. It's hard work digging with the sluice, just makes it that wee bit easier. The water's actually really warm today compared to how this pond gets in winter. I imagine it'd be absolutely freezing, but it's actually nice and warm. see all the black sand here. There's absolutely loads of it. We'll do this one together. I don't know if you can see it. Right here. So at least we got one wee tiny bit. I reckon there'll be more maybe underneath that big massive rock that I can't get under. But that is definitely gold right there. So we'll go for now. Thanks for joining me on this adventure. Another prospecting hunt. And bye for now.